In celebration of the Halloween season and a continuing tradition of this channel going back to the early days, here are 10 spooky things that the universe does or may do that are currently invisible to us and we have no control over. Number 10. Dark matter. While studying galaxies, it became evident to scientists that the visible material contained within them couldn't account for the observed gravitational effects. This led to a conundrum. Either something was fundamentally wrong with our understanding of gravity and physics in general, with gravity already being murky territory, or there was some unseen, invisible, almost entirely non-reactive material in the universe that not only reacted only through gravity, but apparently constitutes the bulk of matter in the universe, as much as 85%. While the existence of dark matter is fairly widely accepted within physics, it's not universally so, and a small contingent of scientists believe that instead there may simply be a problem with our physics on huge scales. This would not be unheard of. Einstein's relativity came out of small discrepancies found within classical Newtonian physics. But if dark matter does exist, it's thought that it may be made up of non-baryonic subatomic particles that have yet to be discovered, and they would be very difficult to discover indeed if they only interact with everything else through gravity. Gravity on the subatomic level is unbelievably weak, but it's interesting to think about the idea that you yourself, right now, are surrounded by an invisible halo of non-interactive material that we know almost nothing about, and there's a chance that we never will. Number 9. Dark energy. Just a few decades ago, it was assumed that the expansion of the universe would eventually slow and stop due to gravity. Subsequent observations by the Hubble Space Telescope blew that out of the water and indicated that in the early universe, the expansion was actually slower than it is today. The predominant explanation for this is dark energy that drives the expansion of the universe to faster rates, and based on observation, it can be estimated how much energy is involved. As it turns out, a lot. It's estimated that about 68% of the universe is dark energy. Dark matter is about 27%, and only about 5% is normal matter, which actually means that normal matter is actually the abnormal part of the universe. But that's about all that is known. What this energy is and what it might imply are still mysteries. Possibilities are that it is energy inherent to space itself. Space, while it may seem like the ultimate nothing, is actually more of a something, and may be able to have its own energy, which would be spread evenly across it. Since space is expanding, or in other words being created, more of this energy should come into existence as the universe ages and expands. What all this means, and even if we'll ever even know what dark energy is, remains to be seen. Number 8. The Great Attractor. Our galaxy is unfortunately very difficult to see through when you look straight at it through its plane. Step outside some night and look at the Milky Way. It stretches across the sky and we see it as a member of that galaxy sitting out in a suburban location near a spiral arm. What's difficult is seeing through the galaxy from our perspective, as much dust, gas, and stars lay in the way. Behind that mess, however, is something that we cannot directly see, but we certainly see the effects of. It is the gravitational anomaly known as the Great Attractor. The Milky Way is located in a supercluster of galaxies. The center of this supercluster is obscured by the Milky Way, but shows evidence of something with a mass thousands of times the Milky Way lurking there. Astronomers see the effect of this anomaly in the motions and redshifts of galaxies and clusters of galaxies over a massive region of hundreds of millions of light years. They are being attracted towards the anomaly and seem to be being affected by a second phenomenon called dark flow, a non-random acceleration towards the attractor above what gravity might be doing alone. More recent work suggests that the attractor is a huge cluster of galaxies at the center of the greater cluster, not an unexpected state of affairs. But ideas like dark flow seem like an open door for further future mysteries regarding the movements of galaxies. Number 7. Aliens and the Unobservable Universe. Depending on who you ask, intelligent life in the universe is either very, very rare or not. On the one hand, there's no reason that Earth should be special, and there's no reason that we should be unique. Quite the opposite, odds are there are, were, or will be other civilizations in the universe given the sheer number of chances for it to happen. After all, there are an estimated 1 billion trillion stars in the observable universe alone, and that's just the observable universe. We can only see part of it, and we don't know how big it actually is, and it could even be infinite. In which case, there aren't only aliens, but copies of you, or someday will be, almost exactly the same. located an infinite amount of times across an infinite universe. Same goes for any alien civilizations that might be out there. Point is, it doesn't seem likely that we would be alone whether the universe is infinite or not, but wherever we look, we have yet to see a single shred of irrefutable evidence of an alien civilization. Yet, the fact that we exist shows that such things are possible. This inevitably leads us to the Fermi paradox, the question of where is everyone? Solutions to this range from the odds being such that civilizations within a single galaxy rarely exist at the same time, or that advanced alien civilizations don't look like what we envision them to, or simply that the aliens are hiding their presence from us, along with tens of other plausible solutions to the paradox. But say they're simply hiding, do they just wish to not interact with us? Or are they waiting out there for us to venture into space? If so, what are their intentions? Number 6, the invisible death from outer space. About 440 million years ago, a mass extinction event occurred on planet Earth that seems to have been very different from the other major mass extinction events that have happened here. While there are a number of hypotheses that might fit the cause of this extinction, one of the worst Earth has ever seen, one idea that's consistent with the beginning of the extinction cascade is that a high-energy gamma-ray burst originating from far outside the solar system almost instantaneously burned off half of Earth's ozone layer, exposing surface or near-surface dwelling organisms to very high levels of ultraviolet light, causing their extinction. One possible explanation for this is the occurrence of a hypernova about 6,000 light-years from Earth. While there is no solid evidence for this occurrence, it merely fits the bill, future gamma-ray bursts within the Milky Way do pose a threat to life on Earth. There are actually several different identified types of gamma-ray burst, and depending on circumstances, there are two ways they can kill Earth life. One is the aforementioned rapid depletion of the ozone layer, but if coupled with a release of cosmic rays, they could irradiate the surface directly, essentially killing a large portion of the surface life of the planet through radiation sickness. This brings up a star known as WR104, which may pose a threat. This system, which is about 7,400 light-years away, is set to produce at least one gamma-ray burst within the next 300,000 years. If the relativistic jet from this burst is pointed at Earth, which there is some indication that it might be, then it could pose a threat to Earth and eventually cause a mass extinction, and we may never see it coming. Number 5. Panspermic microbes. The microbial world is notoriously difficult to see, at least without the right equipment. But it's very evident in such things as food spoilage and infections. But we also know that some of the microbes represent the epitome of resilience of planet Earth, with species that have been identified that can withstand very high amounts of radiation, orders of magnitude more than a human, and even species that can completely dry out and remain dormant for very long periods of time. Because of this resiliency, it has been suggested that microbes might be able to survive traversing space inside rocks, at least to other bodies in the solar system, and conceivably further. While no evidence of this has yet been seen, it's not that far of a stretch to suggest that life might have appeared on bodies like Venus or Mars just as easily as Earth in their past history, or for that matter bodies like Europa or even Titan. This opens up the possibility that microbes from another world might end up deposited on Earth unseen, or it's also possible that life on Earth originated from somewhere else and was transported here. Who knows where we are originally from? Number 4. Outside the simulation. One somewhat vexing possibility with the universe is that it may not be real in the sense of an actual universe, but instead is a simulation. On the one hand, it doesn't intuitively seem like one, and if it were a simulation, it seems rather expensive and wasteful. On the other hand, if it's some kind of ancestor simulation, an argument put forth by Nick Bostrom, that one of three things must be true. Either the number of civilizations that can create such a simulation is nearly zero, or the number of civilizations that choose to do something like that is nearly zero, and if not those, then it becomes likely that you do live in a simulation. So given that line of thinking, if it is a simulation, then what's outside it? Who created it, if anyone? Given that we're in here and all of that is out there, it's unlikely that we'll ever know. Number 3. Vacuum decay. The universe is permeated with quantum fields that essentially hold reality together. While most of these fields appear to be stable, there's one that might not be. It's the Higgs field and its associated particle, and they are what lend mass to the universe. What's uncertain about the Higgs field is if it's actually stable. Think of it like this. You are on a mountaintop holding a bowling ball. You roll the ball down the hill, but it becomes stuck, say in a small valley or ditch. There's plenty more mountain to go down, the ball just can't get there without something agitating it and getting it rolling again. That may be the case with the Higgs field, and it may be analogous to a false vacuum. It may appear stable, but it has more energy than it would like to have. This opens up the possibility of it eventually collapsing to a lower energy state. One way for this to happen likely requires an enormous amount of energy, but another is via quantum tunneling. Could the Higgs field tunnel spontaneously to a lower energy state? Possibly, and if it did, it would be the end of the universe as we know it. As the change in state propagated through the universe at the speed of light, it would leave in its wake a universe with fundamentally changed laws of physics. This might mean that matter as we know it can't exist at all, or chemistry may be dramatically altered, and any number of uncertainties might create an entirely new reality. But one thing is for certain, life almost certainly will not survive it. Number 2, the multiverse and many worlds. One of the most vexing questions within physics today is if there is more than one universe. Much of the reasons for this lies in interpretations of quantum mechanics. But another part of the reason for this thinking is that this universe, given the hundreds of variables and values that allow it to exist as it does, looks a bit strange. If a few things were off, then matter couldn't exist at all, or the laws of physics and chemistry might be radically different. Even the idea of time itself happening to move forward is an open question as to why. And all of this happens to come together in just such a way to not only allow the universe to coherently exist, but for intelligent life to exist within it. That problem goes away in the concept of a multiverse. In that event, there could be many or even an infinite amount of universes. Some might turn out like ours, the vast majority probably not. Some could even just be black expanses where nothing much happens, a fate that's thought to lie for our universe in the very far future. These hypothetical alternative universes take several forms, such as the aforementioned take on the multiverse, but also ideas such as the interior of black holes being gateways to other spin-off universes. But there may be more than that. There is also the many worlds interpretation of the universe, where other realities are constantly splitting off from the universe leading to different paths determined even by the most minor deviations. There could be many versions of you that ate different breakfast this morning or chose a different pair of shoes to wear. While contentious, these interpretations end up more plausible in some ways than the idea of a single, perfectly tuned universe. Any way you cut it, the universe is just weird. Number 1. In the future, no one will see much of anything. We exist at a lucky time in the universe, one where we can look out and see stars and galaxies, at least part of the universe anyway, and it's probably a good thing that we're here to photograph and study it, because in the far future it will be next to impossible to see much of anything out there. As the universe ages, bright star formation will slow and come to an end. Only the very longest lived stars, the red dwarfs, will continue on. But they are dim by nature, and as they become the sole functioning stars in the ever-expanding universe, the galaxies will disappear from the skies, as will the stars themselves. Any civilizations present during this era may not even know there is a universe out there at all. They would only see blackness, and their ability to do cosmology will be severely hampered. They may not even be able to find out how the universe began. This state of the future universe has an interesting implication. If one hypothesis is correct, we're actually very early in the game as far as civilizations go, thus providing a solution to the Fermi paradox, the question of where is everyone. This could imply that over time, the amount of civilizations will rise, and if old ones, such as ourselves, don't go extinct, there could be an explosion of intelligence in the universe more or less right about the time that the stars start blinking out. To these civilizations, the universe might mostly be a mystery, and they might never know how it all began. Thanks for listening. I am science fiction author and futurist John Michael Godier, currently wishing everyone a happy Halloween. I really just use the holiday as an excuse to keep absurd amounts of candy around here at the science lair, but I always seem to find an excuse to do that anyway. My teeth are screaming in fright, and so is my dentist, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.